Hey there, welcome to my sewing room. My name is Celeste and another edition of Friday Sews where we talk about sewing and a little bit of the let's kind of get right into the sewing part of it. I am wearing my latest make. I finally finished my pattern 6529 of New Look and I did View C. Yes, View C. It looked backwards. I thought maybe I was looking at View D. You see, now I've made this before. If you've seen that video, the sleeves were way too long and my collar was not well done. And you wouldn't have known that unless you got really close to it. And I didn't finish my seams with a serger. So that was kind of what my goal was for this project. Now, the sleeve thing I found wasn't the pattern piece being too long. It was actually the fabric that I selected the last time was like that toy from the 70s, the Elastic Man that kept going. And so it just kept stretching. And it was fabric from my mother's stash, so I didn't have to purchase any of that. But it just kept stretching as I sewed it. So I think that was the issue because I used the same sleeve pattern and this one fits perfectly. On me. So, and this is a different kind of fabric. Again, this was from my mother's stash. So again, no cost to me. Very good. So just paid the 99 cents for my pattern for this shirt. I do like how this, was made. I learned from the last project. So some of my skills have improved. My collar is much better. And I was able to use a serger and get this top stitching just right. So it looks like you would find something in a store off the, you know, rack there. So my skills there have improved. So I'm very thankful for that. I did take the time. Every time I talk to you, I get this frog in my head. I did take the time to serge my seams, you know, on the side here. Around the, you know, right here on the sleeves. So I did everything serge to make it look more professional and you can see it here inside my sleeve there. So that makes it look more professional. And my hem, I love how it turned out because it looks like you would buy it from the store. So I serged it and then did the double row of stitching there. So, and it's straight, which is always a good thing. So all in all, I am pleased with the construction of the garment. I think that as you see in this picture, what I'm really hesitant about it is the color that I selected. I'm wearing it today because I have a bunch of errands to run, but I don't think this is a color that really complements my skin color. So it may be one of those shirts that I just wear around the house, or it may turn into something that I sleep in with my cozy flannel pajama bottoms. So we'll see, but I'm wearing it today. I'm pleased with how my sewing skills have improved in the area of the neckline and using my serger to really finish my garment well. I think if I were to ever do this pattern again, I think I might select View D because it has a rounded and a slit on the side. I think that would complement my body shape better than just the straight box look there. So we'll see. I do have enough fabric that I'm contemplating maybe adding the pocket from View B to this one. So again, I said contemplating. I don't know if I'll do that or not. We'll see. Because I do like pockets, you know, on my shirts. But again, improvement. I'm thankful for that. So my next project that I'll be working on will be my reversible apron that I already have cut out. And it's probably going to be a little slower construction because many of you have asked me to do kind of a video sew along with that, and so that is what I'm going to try to do with that, and kind of show you how I use my serger to put this together. So That is the next project that I'm going to be working on. I'm looking at my list because I made a list of things I want to share with you. I probably would also, going back to this, maybe even look for a pattern that's a little shorter. If I'm going to do a box, I think that would be more flattering to me. So in life, let's kind of skip to that. A few months ago, I shared with you that I was participating in a 1,000 declutter challenge, where the challenge is to purge 1,000 things from your home. I began this in July 30th, exactly, 2023. And here it is December, and I have officially purged 522 items from my home. Some very small, some a little bit larger. Some went into the trash can, some went to a thrift store. That helps people who have struggled in the past and are trying to have a new start on life. They provide housing and re-education and jobs and a place to live and food until they kind of get back on their feet. And so many of those items have gone there. So other news in the cooking world, this past weekend we had our staff Christmas party. And so part of it is we took our staff out to eat, and then everybody brought desserts back and we were able to share in that. And so I made our traditional Black Forest trifle. I have a German background, and so a Black Forest cake is something that we've always had at Christmas time. Now, a true German Black Forest cake uses liqueur, but we do not use that in our home. So I've adapted it where I made the chocolate cake from scratch, first time ever. And then I used my cherry pie filling that I canned this summer. This year was a year first in that I taught myself how to can. My husband loves cherries, and so I did that. And so I was very, very proud of it. Next time I make it, I'm gonna actually make the, I use Cool Whip this time, but next time I'm gonna make my own whipped topping, and that way more of it besides the chocolate pudding is made all from scratch. And so I put it in a trifle bowl that my mother used many times. And I tell you what, it was one of the most popular desserts at the Dessert Fellowship part of it. And even some people said, can I take some of this home? And I said, absolutely. So I piled it in the bowl and it went to their home. So that made me feel good because I was able to use things that I canned and things from scratch. And so I was pretty proud of that. I think my husband was tired of hearing, hey, I made that cake from scratch. I'll pop another video up here for you to watch until we meet again next week for another edition of Friday Sews. Have a great day and happy sewing.